support the government as well as measures to combat violence, global challenges, are economic and strategic. For the first time at the UN General Assembly, the Chinese Premier will then travel to Canada and Cuba for official visits. His time in Ottawa will be the first visit by a Chinese Premier to the Canadian capital in 13 years. It comes on the heels of Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau attending this month's G20 summit in China, where he promised the reset of Canadian ties with China after years of stalled ties under the previous Canadian government. Li Baodong says Pekin's time in Canada should help create the conditions needed for that reset.
The economies of China and Canada are complementary to each other, meaning that there is great potential for both sides to further deepen bilateral cooperation at a higher level in vast areas. Such cooperation is also compatible with the common expectation among both peoples.
There are currently around 150,000 Chinese students studying in Canada. The two countries have also announced that 2018 will be the year of China-Canada tourism. From Canada, Li Keqiang will then head to Cuba, making the first visit to the Caribbean nation by a Chinese premier since the two countries established diplomatic ties 56 years ago. Vice Foreign Minister Wang Chao says Li Keqiang's time in Cuba is also expected to open a number of new doors.
Premier Li Keqiang will hold a bilateral meeting with Raul Castro, President of the Cuban Council of State and the Council of Ministers, discussing how to strengthen China-Cuban friendship and cooperation, as well as other issues of common concerns. The two sides will also sign cooperation documents in areas such as the economy, technology, new energy, industry, and environmental protection.
Premier Li Keqiang is due to leave his 10-day trip to North America on Sunday. For CRI, I'm Shuttle.
UN Chief Ban Ki-moon taking time to publicly review some of the